Plastics have become a major problem for our planet. Most of them require fossil fuels to produce, and they can take decades or even centuries to decompose. Plastic recycling doesn't happen nearly as much as we need it to because it's difficult, expensive, and the quality of the end product is often quite poor. In my lab at UC Santa Barbara, we figured out a way to convert the most common type of plastic, polyethylene, into the building block for the second most common type of plastic, polypropylene. The process doesn't require going all the way back to the non-renewable resources that went into manufacturing the plastic in the first place. We start with very long polyethylene molecules. We use a catalyst to remove a little bit of hydrogen, which creates a reactive site on each polymer chain. We use a second catalyst to cut the chain at this reactive location. Ethylene caps the ends of the cut pieces. A third catalyst shuttles the reactive locations from the ends of the new polymer chains back into the middles so the process can be repeated. After all the cutting and capping, we're left with many propylene molecules that can be used to formulate new high-quality plastics. Plastics are incredibly useful and versatile materials. With methods like this that combine smart chemistry with engineering, we can start to build a circular economy that uses existing high-performance materials to create new high-performance materials. And we can begin to recycle more of our plastic waste. And that's my research in 60 seconds.